After more than a week's worth of testimony and evidence, Chandler Halderson is guilty on all 8 counts. The latest on the verdict and what's next. Plus, reaction from the courthouse, what the Dane County District Attorney is saying about the case and who wasn't in attendance. And we talk with one of our own who has been following the trial from the very beginning, his perspective on what transpired. We've got that and more ahead on News 3 Now at 6.
We, the jury, find the defendant Chandler M. Halderson guilty of first-degree intentional homicide as to Bart A. Halderson.
We hope that it brings some satisfaction, although bittersweet.
After 8 days of gripping and graphic testimony, plus a weeks-long delay in this trial, the jury found Chandler Halderson guilty on all charges related to his parents' murders. Halderson faced 2 counts on each of the following charges: first-degree intentional homicide, mutilating a corpse, hiding a corpse, and providing false information on a missing persons investigation. Now, it took roughly 2 hours of deliberation before the jury came back with their verdicts. Throughout the course of the trial, prosecutors argued that Halderson had killed his parents after they exposed a web of lies about his college enrollment and job prospects.
Whoever Chandler Halderson was died years ago as well. And what was left was this shell of a person who made this nonsense up.
Halderson now faces life in prison due to the first-degree intentional homicide convictions, sentencing scheduled for mid-March. In some respects, you may view this as the end of a saga, but Dane County's top prosecutor knows there is work left to do for his team. More importantly, a lifetime of pain and recovery for the Halderson family and their friends. The DA shared some of those thoughts with our Talil Mohideen outside the courtroom just a few hours ago. Talil?
For friends and family of the Haldersons, the jury's guilty verdict was emotional, many nodding along as each count was read by the judge. It took jurors little more than 2 hours to announce Chandler Halderson guilty on all 8 felony counts. The county's district attorney, Ismail Ozan, called the verdict just and true. He also says while they may never know why Halderson killed his parents, Bart and Krista, Ozan hopes the verdict brings some satisfaction.
I'm going to remember each and every one of these faces that are standing to my left. That shining badge of the Dane County Sheriff's Office, the professionalism that they have, the expertise that they have, their dedication to this community, their dedication to the Sheriff's Office, but their dedication to each other and to justice.
We do our best, and we do our best to make sure that we can cover all our bases and prove the charges that we decide to bring beyond a reasonable doubt, and I think that's what happened here.
His brother Mitchell, who testified early in the trial, was not in the courtroom as the verdict was read today, but DA Ozan shared plans to speak with the Halderson family at the trial's end. He also thanked law enforcement for their ability to investigate this case quickly and provide prosecutors with enough evidence to make their case. The case is still considered open as Halderson awaits sentencing, when we will hear from both the prosecution and defense once more.
All right, Talil, thank you. And if you watch any of the trial live on our website, you probably know our digital content manager, James Langer. He's been watching the trial from beginning to end, and he joins us now to discuss today the series of events that led to this verdict. James, welcome. Thanks for joining us. Do you think the fact that the defense didn't really mount much of a case today, did that speak to the volume of evidence that was against Chandler Halderson here?
Yeah, I mean, certainly there was many days worth of evidence to go through. There was 8 days of testimony in the prosecution's witness list, hundreds upon hundreds of exhibits entered into evidence as well. And, you know, attorneys that I've spoken with said it's not really a surprise that the defense took this strategy, because really all they had left was a burden of proof case. They couldn't really argue something that didn't happen, just that the prosecutors may not have proven something happened.
Yeah, we heard a lot of evidence. You know, 2 hours is a pretty quick deliberation. If you cover enough of these cases, we often, you know, kind of sit by and wait for juries to come up with their decisions. This was pretty quick. What do you make of it?
Yeah, it was pretty quick, especially considering they had about 8 charges to get through. They needed to discuss all of those charges and come up with a verdict on all 8. So for them to do that in 2 hours' time probably shows that they were pretty well convinced that this was beyond a reasonable doubt that Chandler Halderson was guilty of these crimes.
Yeah, not a surprise if you watched your coverage. What questions are left here unresolved at this point? Is there anything left the defense can do at this point?
I mean, they can file an appeal, and lawyers I just spoke with said that's usually pretty much what happens no matter what the murder case is. It's just the appeal's chances of being successful. Also, considering he was convicted of first-degree intentional homicide, that's a mandatory life sentence. There's nothing they can really do to argue themselves out of that. All they can really do is maybe push for the possibility of parole in the future.
All right, James Langer, great job covering this trial. We appreciate it. Stay tuned with News 3 Now for more coverage of the Chandler-Halderson verdict. Tonight at 10, we'll have more reaction to the verdict from the courthouse. Plus, if you missed anything from the trial, be sure to check out our page dedicated to it at channel3000.com/Halderson. And there you can find day-by-day breakdowns and a timeline of events from the case leading up to the trial. You can also watch an interview we conducted with Chandler Halderson just before he was arrested. Again, you can find it all at channel3000.com/Halderson. Another big story today. The weather. Let's check your certified most accurate forecast with Chief Meteorologist Gary Kenalty. We're feeling some frigid temps all across the area, Gary.
We are, but the good news, Eric, is that the chances for bitterly cold wind chills are down a little bit because the wind should be pretty light. The live view from the Platteville Kubi Radio Sky Cam still shows a little bit of light on the far western horizon, but skies are clear, and that will argue that we should see a pretty cold night tonight. You can see a Doppler track, no precipitation across Wisconsin. Low temperatures this morning here in Madison. We're down to 2 degrees below zero. It was even colder to the north and west. High temperatures mainly in the single digits. A few places topped out around 10, but right now we're back down to just above zero with a 2 degree temperature here in Madison, and those temperatures continue to fall off. But notice the wind chills really aren't much different than the temperatures because the winds are pretty light. By tomorrow morning, we should be down to about 7 below zero in Madison. Wind chills could hit 15 below zero if we get a breeze at some point. Otherwise, look for a slightly warmer day tomorrow with a high of 17. Then we have some chances for snow this weekend. I'll have more of that in the forecast in just a few minutes.
All right, Gary, and you can stay up to date on the weather with our First Warn Forecast weather app. It has hourly forecasts, road conditions, latest radar. You can download it for free in your phone's app store. Just search WISC weather. Wisconsin Department of Health Services says it is continuing to see a high number of positive COVID cases. Most are the Omicron variant. Today, more than 15,000 new cases were confirmed. The 7-day average at more than 18,000. Right now, 95% of ICU beds and 95% of intermediate beds are in use. Today, Governor Evers and DHS launched the Keeping Kids Safe and in School campaign. It's a statewide multimedia effort that focuses on ways to keep Wisconsin children healthy and in their classrooms.
COVID-19 safety is not just about individual health for our children, but the health of our entire state. And there's a growing body of research that is showing that COVID-19 can have serious long-term effects on our children.
And since the end of August, children in Wisconsin have made up more than 1/5 of new confirmed COVID-19 cases. Public Health Madison and Dane County distributing free KN95 masks to several organizations today. The folks there dropping by the Dane County Emergency Management Office this morning to pick up the masks. Peng He from the Hmong Institute was able to get 1,000 masks for his organization. He says the masks will go a long way toward helping community members.
So I think it's really important to make sure that we have the right masks, the N95, to protect our community and ourselves, and make sure that the underrepresented communities also have access to these masks is really important too.
PHMDC says it had 100,000 masks at the start of the week. Coming up, Wisconsin's unemployment numbers for December are out, and they are record-breaking. Plus, you can help keep those struggling with poverty stay warm this winter. That's next on News 3 Now at 6.
Watching Madison's fastest growing newscast, News 3 Now at 6.
It's here, Wisconsin. Ashley Home Store's Mega Mattress Clearance Event is on now. Millions of dollars worth of in-stock clearance, floor samples, and overstock mattresses must be sold. Line up for savings up to 85% off while it lasts. Plus, no interest financing for 5 years. Only at Ashley Home Store.
Govan Cars is having a huge winter sale with the largest selection of vehicles under $15,995 or $249 per month. That's right. Don't miss out on our winter sale with the best selection of SUVs, cars, or vans under $15,995 or $249 per month. We have one of the largest selections of vehicles in Dane County with over 500 vehicles in stock. So just come on in and ask for me, Crystal the Pistol Govan. Go to Govan Cars, east or west.
You gotta go to Govan, GovanCars.com.
Supply chain backlogs, inflation, agitation.
Here's an idea. If we make things here in America, supply chain issues won't be a thing anymore. That's exactly how we built the Bucks Arena, by having 80% of the materials come from Wisconsin. We did the same by paying higher wages. That's how you know, as your senator, I'll get things done. Raising people's wages, make things in America, finally stand up to China. I'm Alex Lazary, and I approve this message because it's time to put more money in the pockets of working people.
Is your credit score getting in the way of the things you want to do? Personal loans through NetCredit offer fast and flexible lending. Borrow up to $10,000 and choose repayment terms that work for you. You may even be able to build your credit history as you repay. NetCredit, a more personal loan.
What is all this?
We call them options.
Options? Don't make me laugh.
Unbeatable selection without the drama. Two pair plus a free eye exam as low as $59.95.
It's here, Wisconsin. Ashley Home Store's mega clearance event is on now. Millions of dollars worth of in-stock clearance, floor sample, and special purchase furniture and mattresses must be sold. This is your chance to save as much as 85% off while it lasts. Plus, no interest financing for 3 years store-wide. Only at Ashley Home Store.
Want to know what the day's weather will be like where you live? Well, that's easy. Just ask me. Here's how. Record a short video on your phone. State your name, where you're from, and simply say,
I'm Sam from Madison.
Hey, Chris, plan my day.
Then send it to me by email, and I'll give you a personal forecast right here on News 3 Now this morning. This is your chance to be on TV. So just send me a video and say,
Hey, Chris.
Hey, Chris.
Hey, Chris. Plan our day.
Plan your day with Chris, only on News 3 Now this morning.
The Society of St. Vincent de Paul Madison will hold its 30th annual blanket drive January 28th to 30th. The Recycle the Warmth drive started back in 1991 with the goal of replenishing the stock of blankets, bedding, and sheets stored by St. Vincent de Paul to provide to those in need. Last year, St. Vincent de Paul gave away more than $79,000 worth of bedding to over 1,500 families and individuals in need across Dane County.
We know Wisconsin winters are cold. We want to make sure everyone is safe, warm, and secure at home. Blankets are definitely a need we see throughout Dane County.
This year, donors may drop off gently used or new blankets at participating churches in any Dane County St. Vinny's thrift store. Blankets can be purchased and donated January 28th to 30th at each store location. American Family Insurance's Dreams Foundation plans to invest $2.5 million in the Center for Black Excellence and Culture. In early December of last year, Center CEO Dr. Alex G and other local leaders announced a $36 million capital campaign to fund the center. In the past 30 days, the center has raised an additional $5 million from private donations. It is scheduled to open in 2023. Wisconsin's unemployment rate hit a record low, 2.8% in December, after tying the previous low, 3% in November. The state rate below the national unemployment rate of 3.9% for December. Wisconsin gained 5,300 private sector jobs that month. The number of people counted as unemployed in Wisconsin also hit a record low. State Republicans are pushing out multiple bills on Wisconsin gun laws. Coming up, we'll take a more in-depth look at some of them and what it means heading into the midterm elections. Plus, just how cold are these wind chills going to get and how long will they stick around? Gary with the answers, his complete forecast coming up.
To count down the days, but my ski trip to Cascade Mountain with my cousin each year, so much fun. We used to pretend like we were flying. Now, we really do. My dad and my uncle like that we still ski free. But Noah and I, we just have fun. See you there.
Warm up with great deals during Steinhoffel's winter sale. Get store-wide savings of 35 to 50% off the largest selection of in-stock furniture and mattresses. Steinhoffel's has something for every style and every budget at the guaranteed lowest prices. So get in, warm up, and save. You'll find great deals throughout the entire store during the winter sale at Steinhoffel's. Relax, it's Steinhoffel's and steinhoffels.com.
Summer's coming, and so are those warm, relaxing weekends. No matter where your adventures take you, we've got you covered at the new Lake Home and Cabin Show, January 28th through the 30th at the Alliant Energy Center in Madison. Whether you're staying at a vacation rental, towing a teardrop trailer to sleep under the stars, or heading to a beloved family cabin, you'll find everything for your getaway lifestyle at the Lake Home and Cabin Show, January 28th through the 30th, Alliant Energy Center. Every weekend should be this fun.
If you stutter on the phone, speech-to-speech is for you.
Hi, Nihada. This is Andy Smith, and I was calling to see if our home loan has been approved.
A specially trained operator revoices the conversation to the person on the other end of the line.
Hi, Nihada. This is Andy Smith, and I was calling to see if our home loan has been approved.
Oh, Andy, we have great news. You've been approved for the full amount.
To learn more about speech-to-speech relay service, go to wisconsinrelay.com.
You are watching News 3 Now at 6.
And welcome back. We get a sense of Republican priorities heading into the midterms today. GOP lawmakers pushing through bills that relax concealed carry laws. The governor isn't likely to sign them, but that didn't stop the strong majority from marching ahead. Naomi Coles tells us more.
The bills clearing the assembly today broaden gun laws on several fronts, on school grounds, and how old you have to be to conceal one.
Assembly Bill 498, having been read three times, shall the bill be passed?
Expanding gun laws to younger people.
Collectively, what these bills would do, they would allow high school seniors to carry a loaded gun in a car on school grounds, at school events, and while hanging out with their friends after school.
It doesn't say we should be treating people different because they're 18, 19, and 20. Legal adults who can fight for our country, legal adults who can sign contracts.
One bill would allow 18-year-olds to get concealed carry permits, down from 21 years old. Republicans argue that if a teen can vote or join the military, they should be able to carry a gun as well. But Democrats pointed to rising teen suicide rates and school safety, and the fact that federal law blocks anyone under 21 from buying a handgun from licensed dealers.
And this bill would circumvent gun ownership safety measures that most gun owners support.
Another allows permit holders to keep guns locked in their car on school grounds.
This would simply allow them to pull into the school parking lot, pick up their kid, be responsible, and go all about their way. So it doesn't increase the ability of having firearms on school property.
As a parent, as a teacher, and as a citizen, this is terrifying.
Plus, Republicans voted to allow concealed carry permit holders in all 50 states to carry in Wisconsin. Right now, reciprocity agreements block permits from 5 states, and there's special conditions for 8 others.
We're accepting that other states are making good judgments, and we're going to say, you know what, we're going to respect the judgments of those other states related to their citizens. It's not that complicated. It's not that controversial.
The bills go next to the Republican-controlled Senate before hitting the governor's desk. At the Capitol for News 3 Now, I'm Naomi Coles.
The Wisconsin Assembly plans to send Governor Evers a bill that would allow teenagers to work longer hours during the busy summer tourism months. Current law does not allow 14 and 15-year-olds to work later than 7 p.m. from after Labor Day until May 31st and no later than 9 p.m. over the summer. The bill would allow employees under age 16 to work until 11 p.m. when they don't have school the next day. Supporters say the changes will help smaller businesses struggling with the state's worker shortage, while opponents say it rolls back child labor protection laws. Bitterly cold wind chills creating some dangerous conditions out there. Back to Gary for a complete look at our forecast.
Wind chills hopefully won't be as cold as they were last night, but low temperatures this morning were pretty cold. Here in Madison, we dropped to 2 below 0. Temperatures are below 0 to our north and west, and then you get into teens below 0 over northwestern Wisconsin. Much of the northern half of Minnesota saw temperatures 20 below 0 or colder. Current temperatures are not far above those low temperatures from this morning, and that's because skies are clear. The winds are dying down. That will allow the temperatures to fall off a little bit faster, but probably keep the wind chills from being too cold, at least around here. Right now, 2 in Madison, already down to 0 in Dubuque, Iowa, but to the west, already temperatures below 0 through much of Minnesota and northern Iowa, where wind chills are running between about 15 and 30 degrees below 0. Now, those winds are actually out of the south, which eventually will start their temperatures warming up later on tonight, but notice the temperature and the wind chills pretty much the same around southern Wisconsin because our winds are pretty light. So, no wind chill advisory for our area, but there are wind chill advisories through Minnesota, Iowa, northwestern Wisconsin, where the winds will be a little more brisk tonight. Three things you need to know: that one more bitterly cold night tonight with temperatures down between about 5 and 10 below zero. Then a dry and sunny day tomorrow. Temperatures perhaps back up into the upper teens. And then some snow chances. One comes in Friday night, another Saturday night, and then another on Monday. And each of those could bring at least some minor snow accumulations. Longer range future track beginning Friday evening shows the first batch of snow moving through pretty quickly Friday night into Saturday morning. A break during the day on Saturday. The next weather system zips through late late Saturday night into Sunday, early Sunday morning, and then that stops to the south. And then the third one, a little bit stronger, that one comes through on Monday, but notice by 7 p.m. Monday, that's already out of southern Wisconsin. Future track snow from the first system. This is for tomorrow night into early Saturday morning, probably less than an inch of snow. The next one comes through on Sunday, perhaps a little heavier snow out to the west across parts of Iowa, but much of southern Wisconsin still less than an inch from that second system. The third one on Monday, probably a little bit stronger, perhaps a couple of inches of snow out of that. You add it all together, we could end up somewhere in the 2 to 4 inch range with three separate snowfalls, and that takes us through late in the day on Monday. But WeatherTrack right now has our upper level winds coming right out of central Canada. That's why we're so bitterly cold. But notice the jet stream does flatten out a bit to the west before it buckles again. So we'll see a brief warm up over the next couple of days before temperatures turn very cold again by the middle part of next week. Across the Midwest right now, high pressure is located just out to the west of us. That's the center of that cold air mass, but as that high moves across southern Wisconsin, that will actually keep the winds pretty light for tonight. So that's good news, at least in terms of the wind chills are concerned. But for tonight, look for an overnight low temperature of 7 below zero. If there is a breeze at any point, that'll quickly drop wind chills down to about 15 below zero. Tomorrow, mostly sunny, not quite as cold as today. High temperature back up at 17. On future track, temperatures start out below zero early tomorrow morning and then rise up into the upper teens. Tomorrow night, temperatures only go down a couple of degrees, and then that light snow moves through and those temperatures start rising up again later tomorrow night. Saturday, look for high temperatures in the upper teens to lower 20s. And then as the snow moves out early Saturday morning, the next batch of snow will probably move in late in the day on later Saturday night into early Sunday morning. Again, through Sunday morning, probably an inch or two from those first couple of weather systems as far as snowfall is concerned. The third one on Monday, again, brings the potential for some minor accumulations, followed by a shot of very cold air for the middle part of next week. Temperatures closer to normal toward the end of the week with some snow shower chances for next weekend.
And coming up, Wisconsin gearing up for a top 15 showdown at the Kohl Center, where the Badgers say Friday's matchup against the Spartans, it's going to be a dogfight. That's next in sports.
News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
Guys, if you're suffering from erectile dysfunction, Peak Performance for Men has a natural solution that can help you today. That's right. Stop wasting money on pill after pill that just masks your ED. Fix it for good. We can make the difference. Call Peak Performance for Men today.
Stop whitening your smile the old-fashioned way with strips and trays that can take 30 minutes to an hour. I'm Jonathan Greenhut, the CEO of PowerSwabs. When I met Dr. Gineker and he introduced me to PowerSwabs and I saw how effective they were and how easy they were to use, I knew we had to share it with the world. PowerSwabs was clinically studied to whiten natural teeth as well as stained caps, crowns, and veneers. It's so effective, it works on stains caused by coffee, tea, red wine, and even smoking. For those of you who have that one stained tooth that's darker than the rest, Power Swabs can target that area using swab precision.
I really love the fact that you're able to go individually on each tooth and make sure that it's gonna be wider.
So this New Year's, if you have yellowing between your teeth or coffee stains near your gum line, just snap, swab, and smile. And each 5-minute application, you'll see whiter teeth. So stop whitening your smile the old-fashioned way with strips and trays that can take 30 minutes or an hour, and start using the Power Swabs 5-minute solution. Just snap, swab, and smile.
After just 7 days, the results were awesome. Power Swabs was easy to use every day, and each day I could see it better and better, and from beginning to end, it's definitely whiter. They look clean, they feel clean. And people have made comments about it, which is nice.
Call for your 5-minute solution to whiter teeth. This new year, order Power Swabs and receive up to 40% off the retail price. Get a free Power Swabs Quick Stick Pen with your order. The Quick Stick Pen is your on-the-go solution to help prevent stains from adhering to your teeth after drinking coffee, tea, or even after smoking. And in addition to saving up to 40% on your purchase and your free Quick Stick Pen, get free shipping by ordering now. Dial the number on your screen or visit powerswabs.com today.
Exploring Madison's frozen lakes and lagoons can be great family fun as long as you play it safe. Our Time for Kids experts have some advice before you go.
And temperatures are going to stay much colder than average throughout the forecast. We'll have all the latest tomorrow morning from 4:30 to 7.
You could say tomorrow is a huge game for the Badger men's basketball team. Wisconsin, who's tied for first place in the Big Ten standings, welcomes in Michigan State, who sits in third, for the first top 15 showdown at the Kohl Center with fans since 2014-2015 season. And the Badgers know what to expect from a Tom Izzo-coached Spartan team. They play tough and they play physical, and UW is ready to throw the first punch.
He's a fierce competitor. You know, I'm sure that that week of practice for those guys has been hell. But he gets these guys to compete, and expect they're a really good team.
Expecting a dogfight. We've heard that they've been getting pretty physical in practice leading up until this game. So just got to come out and, hit them in the mouth right away.
To Kurtrell Robinson, basketball isn't a game. It's a lifestyle. So no matter if Madison LaFollette is practicing or playing a game, Robinson is getting his Lancers ready to succeed on and off the court by reminding them that every day matters. Kurtrell Robinson knows a thing or two about LaFollette basketball.
Oh yeah, work.
Oh, yeah. It was kind of like a dream job to come back and, coach for your alma mater.
As a player, he won a state championship.
Size him up and then demand your spot.
And now, he's leading the Lancers.
He knows what it means to be a Lancer. He knows what it means to be a high school basketball player that has aspirations of reaching a goal such as state championship. So we trust him a lot.
Knowing what they want and having what they want, and then be able to kind of correlate the life lessons within that, I think is my hook.
Ready.
Robinson's a big thing. Every day matters.
No misses. A year ago from today, we were not in this position. So I constantly remind the boys of this every day.
And the Lancers have taken that to heart.
What you do in the classroom, what you do on the court, what you do when you get home, every single day matters. Anything you do in a day can affect you for the rest of your life.
If you really got a dream, like, every day matters, you got to go work for it. And you can use that in basketball and in life.
Because what really matters to Robinson...
And it's bigger than basketball. I mean, 4 years of high school basketball is great, but now everybody's going to go play next level. So I think the life lessons that we learn within this game, you can carry over in your life.
Ball in.
Having his team succeed in the game of life.
He's a great inspiration to me. I mean, every day I come to practice ready to learn something new. Like, I know that he's going to push me to my max potential. So he doesn't want to see us fail and become like young men outside on the streets. He wants to see us succeed in life and really make it on.
Ball's there. Play, we're live.
And don't forget to nominate your coach to be our next coach of the week. Just head to the sports page on channel3000.com and fill out that nomination form. Gary?
Well, skies are clear, but temperatures are dropping pretty quickly. There's the live view from the WISC SkyCam looking off to the east. Already down to 2 degrees in Madison, 0 in Camp Douglas and the Dells, 1 below 0 in Viroqua. But at least the wind chills are not that much colder than the actual temperature. 4 below 0 wind chill, for example, in Lone Rock, Madison. No wind chill because the air is calm here. Look for a low of 7 below 0. Wind chills at times down to 15 below zero tonight. High tomorrow, 17. Up to 21 on Saturday. Some light snow Friday night, Saturday night. And then again Monday with some minor accumulations. That's followed by a brief shot of cold air for the middle of next week and a warm-up toward the end of next week.
All right, Gary, thank you very much. We want to remind you to stay tuned to News 3 Now at 10 for more coverage on the Chandler Halderson guilty verdict. Tonight we'll have more reaction from the courthouse and expert analysis on the trial. And that's coming up later tonight, again, on News 3 Now at 10, plus more at channel3000.com. Thanks for joining us for News 3 Now at 6. Have a great evening.